Philippine filmmaker Jade Castro and his companions released from jail after being detained for allegedly burning a modern jeepney. A judge junked the destructive arson complaints filed against the group. Police had claimed Castro and his friends were behind the incident that happened in Quezon Province in January. But witnesses and CCTV footage attested Castro's group was not at the scene of the crime. In a press conference, Castro maintained his group's innocence. He also slammed their prolonged detention of over a month.
We reiterate that we are innocent of all charges. All accusations against us are without basis in fact and in law. For us to have been deprived of our liberty following such brazen violations of the law, ethics, standard norms of procedure, made the ordeal of the past 40 days even worse.
Completely unacceptable. That's how former Philippine Senator Francis Pangilinan described the YouTube videos at the center of his cyber libel complaint against a vlogger and officers of YouTube Philippines and Google. Pangilinan says his camp has been monitoring the malicious and libelous content of Bungangera TV since December last year. He also expressed disappointment the YouTube channel was only taken down hours after he filed his lawsuit. Pangilinan urges local businesses and ad agencies to stop placing their ads in videos spreading disinformation. The former senator earlier said Bungangera TV's malicious and libelous videos depict him as someone who abuses his wife and children.
It's about time that the Department of Justice comes up with, and hopefully the courts as well, would come up with legal parameters within which, you know, these social media giants and how we are to address this information. Of course, legislation too. But it cannot work unless the private sector, the business community, of course, the Department of Justice, the academe come together with civil society and citizens come together to fight disinformation.
Philippine House lawmakers expressed their dismay over the no-show of South Korean firm Miru Systems, which was supposed to conduct a demonstration of its automated counting machines. Victoria Tula joins us on the line for the details. Victoria?
Ron, lawmakers were gravely disappointed when the joint venture of South Korean firm Miru Systems Company Limited did not show up in the hearing of the House Committee on Suffrage and Electoral Reforms to discuss the preparations for the 2025 midterm elections. The joint venture won the contract to provide the hardware, software, and election management system. Miru was scheduled to do a demonstration of its automated counting machine during the hearing this morning, but it was canceled. According to Mountain Province Representative Maximo Dalog Jr., Chairman of the House Committee, COMELEC Chairman George Garcia wrote the committee to inform it that they need to customize the machine and take into account the comments of various stakeholders. According to the committee secretariat, since the demonstration was canceled, representatives of Miru opted to not come. Rizal Representative Emigdio Tanhuatco III asked the purpose of the hearing if they could not question Miru. He also said it is a bit disrespectful for Miru to not come since the hearing today was already rescheduled to accommodate requests. For Cagayan de Oro City Representative Rufus Rodriguez, the poll body should have done its due diligence in determining Miru's capability, considering that there are allegations and reports of problematic elections in the Democratic Republic of Congo and Iraq. According to COMELEC Commissioner Marlon Castejo, they have a certification from the Electoral Management Body of Congo and a statement from the United Nations Assistance Mission of Iraq about the execution of elections in the two countries. Rodriguez, however, said the poll body should have sought the side of groups that reported negatively on the elections to know if Miru is truly qualified. He said it is an act of negligence to not do so. ACT Teachers Party List Representative Franz Castro remarked that the background of Miru should have been thoroughly scrutinized before the contract was awarded. Tanhuatco requested to have a demonstration of Miru's machines before the notice to proceed is signed. Representatives of the three Filipino companies, which are partners of Miru, will also be made to attend. Casqueo said he will ask the commission and bank if they could do the next hearing and demonstration next week. Ron?
Victoria Tulad with that story. Thanks.